My dear Chloe, we've spent so much time together this week that I believe I don't have much to say today. Having said that, I was so happy to find your sweet goodbye note when I got home that I couldn't help but make a cup of tea and answer you. I know it will put a smile on your face when you're back from Robin's. I hope you had a safe journey and that it is as sunny over there as it is over here. I am so excited about tomorrow. I can't wait to see the beautiful landscapes of New Valley and meet your dear Robin and his family. I must say that I am also looking forward to dancing and enjoying everyone's company. I still need to bake and prepare everything for the trip, but I thought it would be nice to send you one of my grandmother's anecdotes that she wrote about Rose's garden. I know how hard the feeling is that you can only enjoy her beautiful home because she's no longer here. Not a single day goes by that I don't wish I could share all these with my grandmother. But every time I see her belongings embellish in my home, I feel it is her smiling at me. Every time I make a decision based on what she or Aunt Florence would have done, I feel she's there to guide me. Every time I choose to be kind, I feel she would be proud of me. So I've come to the conclusion that I am still able to share with them as they are here in spirit. I hope this sweet paragraph brings you joy. It is one of the few we have from when they were slightly older. My grandmother Emma wrote it in 1923, after Rose's 28th birthday celebration. After a sweltering week, it felt as if the weather knew that it was Rose's birthday. It certainly wasn't a typical summer day. The morning was rather cold when we left the cottage and headed to theirs. Rose and Timmy were already in the garden. The chaps worked on it almost all morning, weeding, pruning, reporting, and harvesting delicious strawberries, nectarines, carrots, tomatoes, and herbs. Rose and I baked some pies and caught up over a cup of tea. She is looking radiant, and Mr. Spencer said everything seems to be well with the baby. Rose has the feeling it will be a boy, so do I. We prepared some floral arrangements and joined James and Timmy in the garden while we waited for Aunt Florence and Bonnie to arrive. We laid the table and sat down to enjoy the fresh air, the scent of lavender and rosemary, the beauty of the climbing roses, and the elegance of the full-blown peonies. The ladies arrived with their contagious smiles, hugging everyone and giving us boxes of food and presents. Oh, how much I miss them. It has been almost a month since the last time we visited them. We had a wonderful time together, filled with love and laughter. When Aunt Florence kissed me goodbye, she made sure no one was watching, put her hand on my belly and smiled. I smiled back. I don't know how she knew it, but she understood that today was not the day for announcements. Today was Rose's day.